How y'all doing there, folks? My name is Aberdeen Washington, and I'm a proud American and a terrorist fighter. That's right.
Polizia! Polizia!
If you admit to the crime, you'll serve less time. I'll give you 1 minute to decide.
Better not throw me under the bus.
Don't worry, we'll only get 8 years.
Why do I not trust you?
Because I'm your girlfriend.
Yeah, that's the problem.
So, Cordell, did you do it?
Yeah, I shot the tiger. That was a good shot, though.
So, Hannah, did you do it?
Heck no. Blame the racist.
You're under arrest for poaching in the King's Lynn and racist comments regarding an Armenian individual.
See you in 20 years!
There are five characteristics of a monopoly. Number one, a single seller. One firm controls the vast majority of the market, and the firm is the industry. Number two, they sell a unique good with no close substitutes. Number three, the firm is a price maker. The firm can manipulate the price by changing the quantity it produces. For example, shifting the supply curve to the left. Number four, high barriers of entry. New firms cannot enter the market, there are no immediate competitors, and firms can make a profit in the long run. Number five, some non-price competition. Despite having no close competitors, monopolies still advertise their products in an effort to increase demand. There are four barriers of entry. Number one is geography. The location or control of resources limits competition and leads to a single supplier. Number two, the government. Government allows a monopoly for public benefits or to stimulate innovation and can be in the form of patents. Number three, technology. Patents and widespread availability of certain products lead to only one major firm controlling the market. Number four, economies of scale. Economies of scale make it impractical to have smaller firms. Their costs are too high, so they are forced out. Examples of monopolies are De Beers Diamonds, PGE, and Band-Aid. A monopoly is elastic when MR is greater than zero and inelastic when MR is less than zero. At the point where MR crosses zero, the total revenue is maximized. Therefore, when the total revenue is increasing, the monopoly is elastic, and when the total revenue is decreasing, the monopoly is inelastic. A natural monopoly is when the government allows for one firm to exist, even though the firm needs to be subsidized. One firm can produce the socially optimal quantity at the lowest cost due to the economies of scale. It is better to have only one firm because ATC is falling at a socially optimal quantity. Price discrimination is the practice of selling the same products to different buyers at different prices. Firms know that they can ask different prices, which causes the MR line to equal the demand line. Some examples of this are airline tickets, movie theaters, all coupons, Skyview High School football games, and gasoline. There are 3 points of production on a graph. Unregulated, where MR equals MC, but the firm price is at D. The socially optimal, which is allocatively efficient, where MC equals D. And the fair return, which is productively efficient, where ATC equals D. A monopoly is making profit when they produce where MR equals MC, and at that point, D is greater than ATC. But they're taking a loss when they produce at MR equals MC, and D is less than ATC.
Now pause the video and draw a regular monopoly making a profit. What you should have is an MR curve like this, and a MAN curve that's got a slider slope in that, MC curve like this, and then an ATC curve with the bottom being where it crosses the MC curve. And then this, you produce that MC equals MR, and this area right here would be your profit.
Some characters.